free from Fox Die. Free from the system. Free from ID control. Our minds free from their prisons. That is the haven I've yearned for. Not yet free. The war is over. But we still have a score to settle.
That line got me so fired up when I first played it. I really got into it when he said that. I was like, I got so pumped. First time we ever see the arm in this game, because the arm is concealed by his coat throughout the whole entire game. That's interesting, because this is the point where you may start to realize something's up. Series has had so many things like cyborg ninjas, the Illuminati, ghosts, dudes who can control bees, man who can control electricity, the president of the United States in a Dr. Octopus suit, it's giant robots. It's had so many crazy things, and it just all boils down to a fist fight between two really old dudes. That's how the series ends. a fist fight with two old dudes. And I'm not saying that like it's a bad thing. It's just the magic of Metal Gear. It's they make a fist fight between two really old guys. This is crazy. They made a fist fight between two really old dudes. Just really exciting and just so good. And I love Metal Gear. I don't know why I'm laughing at this. I love the Metal Gear series, man. So good. Of course, at the time, we thought Metal Gear Solid 4 would be the final game. We truly thought that. But of course, the fans have been... Oh, what is wrong with me? I don't know why I'm laughing. Oh, I can't even play well, because... I don't know why I'm laughing. I'm starting to feel all giddy, to be honest. Of course, at the time, we thought MGS4 would be the final game. But, nope. Many years later, they are finally creating the Phantom Pain. Kojima have said that they will make the game, make more Metal Gear games after Phantom Pain. But, it will be without Kojima, it seems, because they've had a falling out, of course. Well, Kojima has said he wants the Phantom Pain to be his final game anyway, so even if there wasn't a falling out with him and Konami, I guess they wouldn't make any more Metal Gear games with him. So they will make more Metal Gear games, just without Kojima, they've said. But I've said it before and I'll say it again, is it really, really Metal Gear without Kojima? I just love this fight. This fight is so good. This is the final fight. This is what we thought the series would end with. Because at the time, like I said, we thought this was the end of Metal Gear. So, you can imagine how... We grew up playing these games, so... This is how the series ended. And I'm not saying it like a bad thing. I'm not trying to imply like, oh, this is underwhelming. This is how it ends. This is it. But... No, I'm not trying to imply that at all. Because I loved it. For Final Fight, I thought this was just amazing. I was so... When I played this for the first time. It's great. Take this. It goes without saying, do I need to say this? But of course, the health bars change as you play the fight. We had the health bars from Metal Gear Solid 1. Now they've changed to the Metal Gear Solid 2 fights, health bars. And then a bit later on, we get the health bars from Metal Gear Solid 3 and the music. The music obviously changes to the music from each game as well as you go through the fight. It's just, it made me so nostalgic, this fight. It's crazy. I'm not playing very well at the moment, but I'm just kind of talking and kind of just thinking. That's why I'm not playing so well. I can't wait to see what the final boss fight is going to be for the Phantom Pain. How can they top this? Like, really the only way they can top this is if the final boss fight within the Phantom Pain is between Solid Snake and Big Boss. That's the only way they can top it as far as I'm concerned. A lot of people are saying, oh, I don't want them to end it with a boss fight between Big Boss and Solid Snake because it's predictable, it's what we're all expecting. Yeah, it's what we're all expecting, but I'm not sure what to say. It's what I want to see. It's predictable, sure, but that's what I want to see. I'm not sure what to tell you. I'm sure I'm not alone in this belief. I'm sure a lot of people will agree with me here. But then again, there will be a lot of people there saying, I want them to end the series with a fight which I really don't expect or something like that. I don't know. But I want it to end with Big Boss and Solid Snake. That's the only way they can capture the same feelings that they've captured with this fight. We grew up with the series and just to end it with Ocelot, the guy who's been in all four games. How many times have we fought Ocelot throughout the series? I know at this point he's supposed to be possessed by Liquid, of course, but at the same time it's still Ocelot's body. Because we fought Ocelot in Metal Gear Solid 1, we fought him in MGS3, and we dueled with him in MGS3 towards the end of it as well. Oh, so this is where we go into the phase of MGS3. And I haven't said that because people are saying, oh, I want the Phantom Pain to end on a fight that we're not expecting. How would you feel if MGS4 just ended the fight with some random guy? Like, we obviously expected the final boss of MGS4 to be with Ocelot or Liquid, whatever you want to call him. But it's what we were all expecting, but that's what we all wanted, I guess. I don't think many people are disappointed with this final boss. Most people love this fight, I believe. It's almost universally loved. I'm going to do nothing here. A little Easter egg for you. If you do nothing when he's choking you, yeah, he just kisses you. That's great. This is one of those fights that I love so much, so I'm disappointed when it ends. I want it to last as long as possible. So when it does end, I'm kind of just like, oh. My ideal ending for the Phantom Pain is that they end it with a remake of Metal Gears 1 and 2. Again, it's one of those things where a lot of people are saying, oh, I really don't want it to end like that because it's what I'm expecting. It's what we're all expecting. But I don't really see how else could they end it. And some people are saying, oh, perhaps, what if they end it with a remake of Metal Gear 1 and 2 from Big Boss's perspective? And then the final boss fight is with Solid Snake, and it's an unwinnable boss fight. I like that idea, but I prefer just it being a remake of Metal Gear 1 and 2, where you play as Solid Snake. Because how would you play it if it was from Big Boss's perspective? That's what I don't understand. It's just going to be you watching a bunch of security cameras, watching Solid Snake go through your facility. So I don't understand what people are expecting if you play it from Big Boss's perspective. Like, what sense does that make? Like, how can they do it from a gameplay point? Honestly, I'm just letting him kill me here because I just want to do the fight again. On a tree frog, it's ordeal, the trial to survive. For the day we see new life. I didn't do that on purpose. I just want to play the fight again. I do that sometimes with my favorite boss fights. When I'm about to kill the boss, I just let them kill me so I get to play again. It's just perfect. I mean, on top of a massive ship, that's where the final boss takes place. They always have cool locations for the final bosses though. On top of Metal Gear Rex, on top of the Federal Hall in New York City, in that white, like really beautiful looking flower field in MGS3. And now we're on top of this massive ship with the sun setting in the background. So the music playing right now is the alert music of MGS1. Yeah, it is. It is, yeah. This isn't the same boss music though, is it? This isn't the music that plays during the Foxhound boss battles in MGS1, does it? I don't think it is. Or it might be a slightly remixed version, I'm not sure. If you press triangle when Ocelot does that, you can taunt back and that increases your health. I don't think many people know that, but yeah. Are there any controls that I don't know about? If you hold L1, you block. If you hold L1 and press R1, you do a heavy attack. If you just press R1, you do a light attack. X dodges. If you press X and then R1, you do like a dash punch attack. No, yeah, I know them all, pretty much. Yeah, I was just checking to see if there was any moves that I wasn't aware of. Can you call Otacon? No, you can't. If you try to pause the game, you can't. I was wondering if you could call Otacon there. Never mind. That's what we want to see. We want to see these cool interactions we can do with the environment. Oh, you can strangle him as well. I don't really do that. It doesn't seem to do much damage. I mean, you have to wait for his O2, his oxygen bar to go down before it starts to drain his health. But it takes too long, so I never bother doing that. That's another reason I kind of killed myself on purpose, is because I didn't seem to interact with the environment a lot during that little playthrough, during my first attempt. So I kind of wanted to replay the fight so I could hopefully trigger these cool interactions with the environment. And it seems to be working out quite well so far. Every time you enter a new phase, Liquid's health bar does seem to increase as well, slightly. So that was one thing I was kind of pleased about as well when I first played it, because I was punching him and his health was going down really fast, and I was thinking, man, this boss, final boss fight, it's cool, but his health is going down really quickly. And then we entered the second phase. Right now, this is going into the second phase. So I was thinking, oh no, this boss fight is going to be over really quickly because his health is going down so quickly. But then we ended the second phase and his health bar is then I realized that his health bar is increased every time you enter a phase. So then I was like, oh cool, so it's not going to be over as quick as I thought it would be. So this music is from the tanker chapter of MGS2. Some people might be thinking, oh, wouldn't they play the Dead Cell boss music for MGS2's phase? Well, I guess it wouldn't really make sense because you're playing a Solid Snake right now, so it would make sense to play the music that plays during Solid Snake's segment of Metal Gear 2, MGS2. Because of course, you only play a Solid Snake on the tanker of MGS2, so it makes sense to play the music from the tanker of MGS2. Having said that, Solid Snake wasn't in MGS3. Of course, you were a big boss in that game, so there's not really any music that you can play which relates to Solid Snake in that game. So they just said fuck it, and they played the Snake Eater theme music. Not that I'm complaining, that music is great of course. So, if there's anything you would play from MGS3, it would be the Snake Eater theme music of course. I'm not really concentrating here, I'm kind of just mashing the R1 button and occasionally blocking. I'm kind of just thinking of things to talk about here. Someone name me a better final boss than this. There's never, like, just this part of the game, it just had such a big impact on me when I played it. So I was thinking, this is the end of an era, this is the end of Metal Gear Solid. Of course, we got the Phantom Pain coming out now, but back then, back when we played this, we thought this was really it. We thought this was really the end of Metal Gear Solid when we played this. So this, as I've said before, this fight, it had such an impact. I really hope the Phantom Pain is good. I really hope it blows me away. The thing is, I played Arkham Knight recently, Batman Arkham Knight, and it wasn't exactly I just want to say I was really disappointed with Arkham Knight. I didn't think it was that good. I was expecting a great game, and when I played it, I was like, this is it. Don't get me wrong, it wasn't awful, but it was pretty disappointing, in my opinion, of course. But with something like Arkham Knight, it's just like, no matter what the final boss was going to be for Arkham Knight, it wasn't going to be anything which really I really would be amazed by or anything like that. But with MGS, I grew up with these games, so it's just this final boss. It's, I don't think any game can ever have a final boss which impacts me as much as this did. And they don't just increase Ocelot's health bar, they also increase your health bar with every phase you begin, so it makes the fight fair. And this fight was actually pretty tough on Big Boss, on the hardest difficulty. It did take me quite a lot of attempts.
What a fear in
splendid.
I'm gonna kill him for real this time. No more messing around. It's time to end this. It's time to end Mega Gear Solid 4. Entering the fourth phase. One more hit should do it. The fight is practically over at this point. There's no strategy at this point, you just mash R1 as fast as you can to punch. As long as you do that, you can't lose. This part of the fight is just tap R1 as quick as possible. You can't lose, it's just... At this point, it's kind of like a glorified cutscene. But in a good way. I do like how, at this point, everything is over. Everything is done. The Patriot AI it's been destroyed. Vamp is dead. Solid Snake and Ocelot, they're kind of like the only ones left alive. Well, I mean, Ocelot is the only bad guy left alive at this point, but his plans and everything's finished. Everything is over at this point. But Solid Snake and Ocelot, they're fighting. At this point, they're just fighting because they can. They're just fighting because why not? That's another thing I really like about this final fight. They're not fighting for anything at this point. At this point, they're just fighting because it's the only thing left to do.
Created by man, unless the light is put out,
The shadows cannot be erased. So long as there is light. Erasing shadows will do no good. I am Liquid's doppelganger. And you are his. Just like your father. You're pretty good.
You're pretty good.
Pretty good.
Sunny's program destroyed JD's brain, but left the brainstem intact. She analyzed Naomi's black box and separated the Patriots' control system from the vital lifelines of society. Water, air, electricity, food, medicine, communication, transportation. She cut off the Patriots' control while preserving modern civilization. Maybe it was her way of avenging Olga, her mother. Or maybe she wanted to shape the future into her own ideal image. Or maybe it was just one big defragmentation. Fox alive. The AI is truly living thing. The Patriots' reign has crumbled away. And still, our civilization, a civilization that has thrived on war since the dawn of time, lives on. I wonder if we did the right thing. Naomi, what did we lose? What did we save?
Yeah, I don't have much time left to record today, so I guess I should save the game and I'll watch the cutscenes some other time. Not that it matters to you, since you're watching it on YouTube, and obviously, it'll all be edited together anyway. But for me, it'll be a day until I can record again. I guess I'll pass you over to my future self from here.
Congratulations.
Colonel. Mm. You're going to walk me down the aisle.
You're not angry anymore.
Oh, I'm still mad. But now, you've got a chance to win me over.
You're right. We have plenty of time now. Meryl. You look beautiful.
I'm really not too sure about this whole part of the ending. This whole Mel ends up marrying Akiba or Johnny. It feels a bit like fan fiction, I guess. It doesn't really feel like something could. It just doesn't feel right to me. It feels a bit too out there, I think. Although this isn't the biggest problem I have with the ending, so in comparison to What's to Come, I don't really mind this.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to join these two in holy matrimony. Let us give thanks for the life they will soon share. And pray they have love everlasting. Now, let's all send this new team on their first mission. Hey, go on, do it.
Just in time,
dragon.
And I brought gifts. A shower of flowers, compliments of Drebin. And a little something extra for me.
Okay.
Who knows? That guy always keeps you waiting.
I'm guessing by here they were trying to bait you into thinking that that person by there is Snake, but of course, it's just Raiden. Oh yeah, I was about to say, I guess they gave him new arms now. Of course he lost them when he got crushed under the ship.
Jack, how are you feeling? Do you mind if I sit down? Jack. Don't shut me out. I need you to listen to me.
What do you want? Come to laugh at me?
Oh, no. Look. Look at the boy.
Cute. Campbell's kid.
No!
With hair like that, does he really think that's Campbell's kid?
He's yours.
I don't have any kids.
He's your son.
You said miscarriage.
I lied. I had a healthy baby boy. Roy pretended to be my husband, to protect me and our son. Only until you completed your mission, to shield us from Patriot eyes.
What?
He didn't even tell Meryl. He sacrificed everything, even his family, to protect us.
I don't believe it.
I'm sorry, Jack. I wanted to tell you.
So he's really...
John, aren't you going to say hello?
My son. Little John. Scared of me, huh? I don't blame you. It's okay.
I'm not scared. I think you're cool. kind of like a comic book superhero. Here we go.
I'm curious as to whether or not Rose makes an appearance in Metal Gear Rising. I haven't played the games, like I've said before. I'll get around to it one day.
No, Beast. You're my husband. And his father. And me.
He's such an edgelord in this game. I really don't like Raiden. I prefer this MGS2 counterpart.
Mother, this family deserves.
This is the cutscene we've all been waiting for. Of course, the boss's grave. And then I'm pretty certain that's Big Boss's grave. Well, I mean, Outer Heaven, like, makes sense.
War has changed. Our time has ended. Our war is over. But there's one more thing I must do. Punishment I must endure. Erase my genes. Wipe this meme from the face of the earth. This is my final mission.
Halle Chavad don't think I really need to say anything there. That cutscene pretty much speaks for itself. Of course, the first time I watched it, it was pretty dark. It was quite grim. So I grew up playing the Metal Gear games. So obviously, to watch them just take Snake out like that was kind of heartbreaking.
I thought it was strictly soda for you.
Not like I never touched the stuff.
Soda just agreed. It's kind of cruel, but it had to happen.
The nanomachines break down alcohol before it has a chance to get you drunk.
So, that explains it. No need to hold back anymore, huh?
Yeah, well, it ain't all sunshine and rainbows. A lot of folks lost their entire sense of being the moment SOP went offline.
You mean SOPS? I heard some people are going through withdrawals. SOP syndrome.
Yep. SOP kept more than just alcohol under control. Those poor slobs are virtually naked now.
From what I hear, over 10% are showing symptoms. I guess getting rid of the Patriots won't solve all our problems overnight.
You, probably already suspected this, but I'm not actually an employee of AT Security.
Huh?
The Patriots raised me to be a gun locker.
The Patriots?
My earliest memories are of the LRA. They kidnapped me, forced me to fight. Yep, you're staring at a former child soldier. My parents, brothers and sisters.
Those are pictures of Raiden when he was a child soldier. They were shown back in MGS2 when Solidus was revealing to Raiden his backstory.
Family business. I was Drebin. Number 893. There's a whole lot of pawns like me all over the world. How do you suppose I laundered guns like I did? 'Cause they let me. In fact, I was under strict orders to back you guys from the start.
You what?
Hey, man. Don't take it personal. I wasn't the only one under their orders.
Huh? Merrill and...
They probably never realized it themselves, but... Rat Patrol, Team 01. Voila. Played like a violin.
But why?
Obviously, Liquid's plot was a threat to the Patriots. So they planned to have you guys take care of it.
Didn't turn out quite how they planned, though, did it?
Yeah, well, I don't think they expected you to crash their system and wipe them out.
So, does that mean you're out of a job now?
Are you kidding? I got the Drebins. All the Drebins in the world are in on it. From now on, we're in business for ourselves. We are pawns no more.
Easy there.
The White House might have lost its taste for unilateralism, started to rebuild. But there's a lot of failed states out there that went bankrupt from their PMC habits, and they owe a shitload of money. Now, only question is, who's gonna pick up the tab? I'm sure these new governments will try and keep it under control with PMC corporate reform laws, but it ain't gonna be good enough. They all sunk up to their eyeballs in the war economy. Might not be a new world order, but the old order under the war economy's gone for good. I'm guessing the UN is gonna be more important than ever, what with multilateralism and all. A certain president said it best back during the Cold War. For in the development of this organization rests the only true alternative to war. Then again, the UN itself's just an old 20th century relic. And if you think about it, when you look at its history, it ain't that different from the Patriots.
That's right. The nanomachines used to keep you sober.
Crush. Mix. Burn. Repeat.
Hey, Uncle Hal, can I give him the Mark III?
Huh?
He's kinda a new friend. He lives near here. We can't understand each other's language, but we're having fun. He's my very first outside friend.
Really? That's great. Sonny, it's okay if you want to live outside now. It's your life. There are other havens out there.
The sun looks so pretty.
Sunny.
I like it outside. Uncle Hal, when is Snake coming back?
Snake? Is sick. So he went on a trip to help him get better.
We're not going with him?
No. He needs to be alone.
Never see him again.
Snake had a hard life. He needs some time to rest.
Are you crying, Uncle Hal?
Not crying.
I gotta say, when I heard what the original ending was for MGS4, I was pretty pissed off, because to me the original ending was infinitely, well, way better, let's just say that. And I think it's kind of 50-50 here. Some people really like the original ending, as well, some people don't. Personally, I think it's much better than what we got, let's say. I'll explain what the original ending was in a moment, in case there's someone watching this who doesn't know. But yeah, I do prefer the original ending way better than what we got here. But yeah, that's MGS4. I think it's not my favorite numbered MGS. I can never decide what my favorite numbered MGS is. But I can safely say that 4 is not my least favourite numbered MGS. Like, that's not to say I don't like it. I do love all of the MGS games. And I love MGS 4. It's just, I can safely say it's not my favourite, that's all. Doesn't mean I don't like it. It just means I know for certain I like 1, 2 and 3 slightly more than 4. But of course, it's not over yet. And Richard Doyle, he was the guy who voiced the Fury in MGS 3 as well. I guess because he had such a great voice, they decided to bring him back. Oh god, it's not over. I wish it was though. I wish it didn't keep going.
That's right. Good. No need for you to go just yet. It's been a long time, Snake.
It is cool to see Big Boss again, but it's unnecessary. It just... They are about to reveal a lot of information, which just makes the plot way more complicated than it needs to be. I mean, you think the story was complicated right now? You wait until you hear what he has to say. He just makes things 20 times more complex. I was thinking when I first played this, oh, it's one more boss fight, we're gonna have to fight him in the graveyard. That would be a really cool fight, but he's not here to fight, as we're about to find out.
Let it go, my son. I'm not here to fight. Or should I call you brother?
What?
It's over. Time for you to put aside the gun and live.
Although this scene does have a lot of really touching moments, I still think it's... I would rather not have it in the game. Although it does have a few great moments.
Bunch of old fools. Now, they've all passed away. Their era of folly is over. I'm the only one left, and soon I'll be gone too.
How can you still be alive?
That body, liquid burned on the Volta, wasn't mine. That was the body of a clone. Solidus. He was a perfect clone. Zero and the proxy AIs that came after him.
A lot of people question how Ocelot could control the SOP system, because they needed Big Boss's DNA in order to gain access to the SOP system. So how could he do it if Big Boss wasn't really Big Boss? Well, Big Boss at that time was obviously Solidus, and they thought it was Big Boss's body. But Solidus is a perfect clone of Big Boss, as they said, which is why his DNA did allow Ocelot access to the SOP system.
To restrain the B&B members you encountered. For me to wake again, the system had to be destroyed, one way or another. Ocelot and Eva wanted two things. To bring me back to life, and to end the Patriots. That meant destroying the AI and killing the man, JD and Zero. Right before you uploaded the virus into GW, the way to JD was opened, but only through the physical manifestation of GW. That's when we finally learned the location of this man, Zero. For me, and for them, for Naomi, nothing was more important. And it was for that that they put their grand scheme into motion. Eva stole my body from them and reconstructed it by replacing the missing parts with pieces from Liquid and Solidus.
He's given so much information here, I can never remember all of it.
In order to fool the system.
So even I, at this point, I'm trying to just...
And psychotherapy to transplant Liquid's personality onto his...
Oh, that's the worst part.
He used hypnotic suggestion to turn himself into Liquid's mental doppelganger. For all our advances...
I don't know what Kojima was thinking.
Information and genetic control. They've never managed to control people at will. Let alone turn one person totally into another.
So, Liquid wasn't really possessing Ocelot the whole time. It turns out Ocelot was hypnotizing himself.
Like someone else. Cats. Duels.
So he was hypnotizing himself into thinking he was Liquid. Okay. The possession thing makes more sense, to be honest.
Zero. Zero grew old, and by the end his Patriots were being run by a network without shape or form.
What do you mean, without shape or form?
Proxies were only one small part of the vast cycle that Zero created. The corporations, for-profits, and research institutions that comprise the military-industrial complex were part of it too. They operated on budgets automatically allotted to them by the proxies. Accounts maintained by the Patriots. The network covered everything from weapons R&D and investment to production and marketing. It encompassed the people, the companies, even the laws that protect them. Politics and economics became nothing more than iterations of the same oppressively uniform system. I don't think anyone realized that it was all a setup, a mere set of norms. The Patriots were those norms. A neural network reduced to its simplest form. That's what they really represented. Uniformity without individual will, without change. But then one day, those norms suddenly deviated from that pattern and underwent a mutation. It was like the birth of a new life form. The system found a new way to propagate itself. War. The norms the Patriots had crafted for their unified state quickly became dependent on a single business. The war economy.
So he's basically saying that Zero created the Patriot AI. With good intentions. He wasn't evil. He didn't set up the Patriot AI with evil intentions. But when the Patriot AI was created, it kind of evolved into this. It basically evolved into what it became, this kind of evil entity.
Began to reproduce and take on a life of their own. Zero's original intent was to carry on the boss's will and establish a unified world state, an inside world. But his successors failed to carry on his will. Eventually, JD became the very age itself, propagating its will as it pleased. And this age chose to act through economics instead of nation states. Powered by the industrial and digital revolutions that came before it, this age gave birth to a twisted economic revolution, a battlefield revolution. It created a new world without substance. In this new world, there were no ideologies, no principles, no ideals, not even the thing she treasured most, loyalty. There was only the war economy. It was a colossal error in judgment. One Zero couldn't possibly have foreseen.
Doesn't quite make Zero a good guy either, because both Zero and Big Boss did bad things when they were younger. They both did pretty inexcusable things when they were younger. But now they're kind of old men, and Big Boss is kind of just filled with regrets for what he's done in the past.
Was the source of it all. And he doesn't even realize it. He's completely unaware of the fact that he led the world to the brink of ruin. Even with so much bad blood between us, it's funny. Now that I'm actually face to face with him again, the hatred is gone. All I feel is a deep sense of longing and pity. Did Zero really hate me? Or did he fear me? It's too late to ask him now. The original members. Paramedic, Sigint, Eva, Ocelot. They've all passed on. Only Zero is left. Everything has its beginning, but it doesn't start at one. It starts long before that. In chaos. The world is born from Zero. The moment Zero becomes one is the moment the world springs to life. One becomes two. Two becomes 10. 10 becomes 100. Taking it all back to one solves nothing. So long as Zero remains, one will eventually grow to 100 again. And so, our goal was to erase Zero. Even the mighty Patriots began with a single man. That one man's desires grew huge, bloated. Absorbed technology began to manipulate the economy. We realized too late that we had created a beast. We had helped turn Zero into 100. His sin was ours. And for that reason, I'm taking it upon myself to send Zero back to nothing.
Thank you.
you going back to zero as well.
You erased me 2 times before. Today will mark the 3rd. The fox die, Zero planted in you. It's already begun eating away at my body. Truth is, the fox die in you is what killed Eva and Ocelot.
What are you talking about?
Hail me. She told me everything.
What's wrong?
They did it again. Oh, they used you to kill me. The Patriots. No, they're proxies. In order to bury us, they did it again. In the end, they're no more than a program. All they can do is repeat the same pattern over and over again. Do me a favor, will you? Take me over to her. There's one more thing Naomi wanted me to tell you about the old fox dye in your body, the one that mutated, the new fox dye inside you continues to multiply. At the same time, it is preventing the old, mutated fox dye from reproducing. The new fox dye is uprooting the old. Naomi confirmed it in her follow-up. The mutants.
When did Naomi tell Big Boss this? Because Big Boss was in a coma up until Snake destroyed the Patriot AI during the final act. So did she like leave Big Boss a note? And also, another thing which doesn't really make sense is why didn't Naomi just tell Snake this anyway? Why leave this information to a guy who was in a coma? Like, shouldn't she have just told Snake this? Guess what if Big Boss showed up 1 second later? Snake would have killed himself in this graveyard. Like, it seems pretty stupid and risky, because she had no way of knowing when Snake was going to kill himself, and she had no way of knowing if Big Boss would be able to find and reach Snake in time. Not only that, they wouldn't know that Snake was going to come back to this graveyard to kill himself, so that part doesn't really make much sense.
Am I going to die?
Everyone dies. You can't stop it. You can't run away from it. Let me tell you something. Don't waste the life you have left fighting. I never thought of you as a son. But I've always respected you as a soldier and as a man. If you'd been in my place, the same mistakes that I did. Ever since the day I killed the boss with my own hands, I was already dead. Boss, you were right. It's not about changing the world. It's about doing our best to leave the world the way it is. It's about respecting the will of others and believing in your own. Isn't that what you fought for? At last, I understand the meaning behind what you did. At last, I understand the truth behind your courage. Yours to live in, not as a snake, but as a man. Zero and I, liquid and solidus, we all fought a long, bloody war for our liberty. We fought to free ourselves from nations and systems and norms and ages. But no matter how hard we tried, the only liberty we found was on the inside. Trapped within those limits. The boss and I may have chosen different paths, but in the end, we were both trapped inside the same cage. Liberty. But you have been given freedom. Freedom to be outside. You are nobody's tool now. No one's toy. You are no longer a prisoner of fate. You are no longer a seed of war. Oh, it's time for you to see the outside world with your own eyes. Your body and your soul are your own. Forget about us. Live for yourself.
Okay, so that's the real ending of MGS4. So from what I understand, to try and sum all of that up, because they dump so much information in that one cutscene, it's a lot to process, and some of it, I'm not sure if it all makes sense. And Mei Ling and Raging Raven have the same voice actor, apparently. Did I just read that right? If so, whoa, okay. That's a cool, I never knew that, okay. So from what I understand, basically the Patriots were kind of... You can split the Patriots up into the good Patriots and the bad Patriots. The bad ones were Sigint, Paramedic, Zero. Yeah, that's pretty much the bad Patriots. And then the good ones were Ocelot, Eva, and... Big Boss was a bad guy. But he was trying to bring down the bad side of the Patriots. Eva and Ocelot were kind of like the truly good Patriots. While Big Boss became a crazy asshole in The Phantom Pain and Metal Gears 1 and 2. Of course, The Phantom Pain isn't out yet, but we're going to see what a crazy asshole he became. Unless they try and pull a twist where it turns out the Big Boss was the good guy all along and he was framed by Cypher or something like that. I don't know, The Phantom Pain will reveal all, of course. I hope they don't try and pull some twist like that. I hope it's just black and white, clear as day, Big Boss is the bad guy. I hope they do that for The Phantom Pain. I don't want some bullshit, stupid twist like Grey Fox, that you're playing as Grey Fox the whole time. Or the person you're playing as is some test subject that Cypher is using to frame Big Boss as the bad guy. I really hope they don't do some sort of stupid twist like that. Anyway, so from what I understand, basically Eva Ocelot, and Naomi, they were all working together throughout the whole entire of MGS4. The three of them were working together to try and bring down the Patriot AI and resuscitate Big Boss from his coma, basically. And then, meanwhile, you had the Patriot AI implant Snake with a new form of fox dye. That they used Drebin to inject the fox dye into Snake, which was programmed to kill either Ocelot and Big Boss, which it did. So you had the Patriot AI working to kill Ocelot, Eva, and Big Boss using the fox dye, which it succeeded in doing. And meanwhile, you had Eva, Ocelot, and Naomi working together to bring down the Patriot AI, which once again, they succeeded in doing. Plus, you know, thanks to Solid Snake, of course. The one thing which is kind of just makes things way more complex than it needs to be is the whole Ocelot was pretending to be possessed by Liquid the whole time. So it turns out he wasn't really being possessed by Liquid. It was all an act. He hypnotized himself into thinking he was possessed by Liquid. A lot of people question why he even bothered doing this. Apparently the explanation is this. The Patriot AI wouldn't deem Liquid as big of a threat as Ocelot, because they already succeeded in defeating Liquid in Shadow Moses in MGS1. So to the Patriot AI, Liquid was not that big of a threat, because they already succeeded in killing him in MGS1. But so, however, they would deem Ocelot a threat. So Ocelot pretended to be possessed by Liquid, so the Patriot AI would think he's Liquid, thus deeming him not that big of a threat. Apparently that's the thing. So I guess the Patriot AI would basically throw everything but the kitchen sink at Ocelot if he was Ocelot. But because he was pretending to be Liquid, they were like, oh, it's not that big of a deal. We'll hold back because we already killed Liquid before. I'm sure we can do it again. Apparently that's the reason. Seems kind of bullshitty to me, but yeah, apparently that's the reason. And another thing which some people question is, if that body that Eva had wasn't really really Big Boss, it was actually Solidus. And the thing is, she knew that the body wasn't Big Boss. She knew it was Solidus's body because she, Naomi, and Eva, Naomi, and Ocelot were all working together. They were together on this with reconstructing Big Boss's body with parts of Liquid and Solidus. So the question a lot of people have is because at the end of Act 3, there's a moment where Ocelot throws Solidus's body into the fire, and then Eva sees the body and she's like, oh no, Big Boss, and then she runs into the fire to try and save him, and then she ends up getting lit on fire. So why would she risk her life and run into the fire if that body was just the body of Solidus? And she knew about this, so why would she even do that? Maybe an inconsistency. Some people say that she's kind of dazed and confused because there's like, at that point, the boat kind of capsized a little bit and she got knocked about. So at that point, a lot of people argue that she's dazed and confused. So she's kind of hallucinating that that's Big Boss's body. She's not thinking straight. Again, it seems kind of convoluted. I think it's more of an inconsistency. This is kind of people trying to save face and desperately trying to make sense of it. That's what I kind of feel about it. That whole entire final scene, it does have a few moments, a few cool moments, like some of the stuff that Big Boss says, I do like a lot. I do like how he's kind of filled with regret. It's cool to kind of see him that way. He kind of regrets doing everything he did when he was younger. He kind of accepts it, and he kind of just regrets it. I do kind of like that idea, and I also like the little moment at the end where Solid Snake picks up the cigar and gives it back to him, and he says, this is good, isn't it? I do like that line. So while that scene at the end does have a few good moments, it just makes everything way more convoluted than it needs to be. And I would have preferred it if Snake just killed himself in the graveyard, I think. Like I said, it's cool to see Big Boss alive again, and it's cool to see him interact with Solid Snake one final time. But it makes so many things way more complex than they need to be. It's just Kojima, man. And also, this was what I was going to talk about, the original ending of MGS4. So, for those of you who don't know, in the original ending, Snake and Otacon would turn themselves in, and they would be executed by the government for war crimes. That's how MGS4 would have ended, with Solid Snake and Articon being executed. I'm not 100% sure why they would be executed. It's something about what they did, the things they've been doing throughout MGS4 would be a reason for the government to execute them. I'm not 100% sure, but basically it would end with the government executing Snake and Articon, which is a really dark way to end it, of course. And that's the way Kojima wanted to end it, but the thing is, his team said were really against it. They were saying, there's no way we're doing that. We do not want to do that. And eventually Kojima, he basically gave in, he folded, and he said, oh fine, we're not gonna kill Solid Snake or Articon. So, because his team was so against the idea of them being executed, Kojima changed the ending to what we got now, which is, well, I'm not too fond of this one. Like I said, it has its moments, but I would have preferred that original ending. And I think it would have been pretty amazing, because think about it, this is the way I'm kind of envisioning it. What if they executed Solid Snake and Articon by the electric chair? So they kill Articon first, and then they execute Solid Snake last. And if you remember in the torture scene in MGS1, Ocelot had Solid Snake up against that bed, that torture bed, and he was being electrocuted. If you remember doing that torture scene, you had to tap circle as fast as possible while his life bar was going down, and you had to tap circle to make the health bar go back up. What if they ended it like that? So that's how the series ends, with Solid Snake in the electric chair. And as his health is going down because of the electric current, the player can make his health go back up by tapping circle as fast as possible. An obvious throwback to NGS1. And as time goes on, the speed that Snake's health decreases gets faster and faster and faster. So the player can last a little while, but after a few minutes, the speed will increase to the point where it's no way a human being can possibly tap the button that fast. So the speed will constantly increase faster and faster and faster until Snake's health finally reaches zero and the game just ends. I think that would have been a really cool way to end it. But nope, this is the ending we got. We kind of gotta live with it. Like I said, it's not the end of the world. It has a few cool moments, but I would have preferred the original ending. Or if not the original ending, I would have preferred it with Solid Snake just killing himself in the graveyard. I think that would have been fine as well. Anything except for that mid-credits scene that we got. But I think that's really all I have to say. So MGS4 as a whole, I do love it just as much as MGS, every other MGS game. It's just that mid-credits scene, I think we could have done without. That's basically what I have to say. Of course, we got one last thing coming up at the end of the credits here. While every other MGS game ended with a twist during the post-credits scene, this one's kind of just like a... Well, there's no twist. There's no swerve at the end of the credits here. Very straightforward. It's just a little moment between Snake and Articon, as we're about to see.
Snake, wait up. You forgot these.
No thanks. I'm quitting.
Snake!
These things will kill you.
Where will you go? Our fight is finished. There's nothing left for us to do.
No. There's one thing I still have to do. I have to see this age off. See what the future brings.
Sounds good to me. I'll go with you.
Articon, I'm gonna be dead soon. You don't have to come.
You said it yourself, Snake. There's nothing inside you can pass on to the next generation. No genes, no memes. You're man-made. You're a beast.
I know. A blue rose. There won't be any happy Beauty and the Beast ending for me. What little time I have left will be spent living as a beast. A shadow of the inside, of the old age.
Exactly. That's why you need me, as a witness.
A witness?
Yeah. Someone on the outside to bear witness to your final days. Someone to pass on your story. Not that I'm the only witness. But I'll remember everything you were and stick with you to the end.
Otacon.
Besides, you wouldn't let me suffer Sunny's eggs alone, would you?
And that's the end of, well, Solid Snake's story in the MGS series. So of course, the future games, Peace Walker, Ground Zeroes, and Phantom Pain are all prequels, so... Well, Solid Snake will be in one of them, the Phantom Pain, of course. But we're not sure to what extent. The trailers show Snake as a kid.
Come quick! They're ready! They look yummy! Sort of like the sun.
Yeah, as I was saying...
It's rising again.
Solid Snake, he will be in Phantom Pain, as the trailers have clearly shown. But to what extent is not entirely clear. We've seen him as a kid, but a lot of us are hoping that the game will span to Big Boss's death and the final part of the Phantom Pain will be a remake of Metal Gear's 1 and 2. Maybe we're expecting way too much, but I would love it. That would be a dream come true if they ended that way. So we're kind of hoping that for the final part of the game, we'll be playing as Solid Snake in a remake of Metal Gear's 1 and 2. Hopefully, and voiced by David Tato, of course, they would have to do that if they truly are going to end the game that way. I still think that's a ruse, because Kiefer Sutherland is voicing Big Boss in the Phantom Pain. And they are claiming that David Hayter... They didn't bring David Hayter back. And David Hayter, if you watch him, like videos of him online or interviews, you can see he's trying to play up this act where he's like, I'm not in the Phantom Pain, guys. And he's trying to play up this act where he's like, yeah, I don't even know what the Phantom Pain is, whatever. It's some new Metal Gear game, I don't care. I'm not buying it. I don't believe him at all. This is all a ruse. I'm 100% confident and certain that David Hayter will be in the Phantom Pain to some extent. Maybe he'll just have one or two lines at the end, or maybe he will have a lot if the game truly does end with a remake of Metal Gear 1 and 2. But either way, he will have some lines in the Phantom Pain. I am 100% certain on that. I'm confident it's a ruse. I'm not buying it at all. Anyway, that's MGS4. I guess I'll be moving on to Peace Walker next. And another thing I'll say is, I do like how they kind of made that the Patriots were kind of working against each other. They were kind of split into two groups and working together, working against each other. So you had Naomi, Eva, and... Naomi wasn't a member of the Patriots, but she did team up with Eva and Ocelot. So I like it how those three were working together to kill Zero, Paramedic, and Sigint. And they did, because... Big Boss killed Zero at the end, but it does, if you think back, they did, because Naomi used Frank Yeager to kill Paramedic between the events of Metal Gear 2 and MGS1, and then Ocelot accidentally killed Sigint during the torture in MGS1. So I do like how it kind of ties in together, and you can think back to those moments, and it does kind of make sense. Not everything makes sense, but that bit does, and I think that's pretty cool that they link it back to those events of MGS1. Anyway, yeah, I'm done for real now, so Peace Walker's next. See you then.